Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from aartiramgopal.com. In this video, you will learn step by step how to convert PowerPoint to video. Now, take a look at this sample video. Now, what you saw was an MP4 video created entirely using PowerPoint. First, I created a slide deck with these slides, added animation, added transition, and added an audio file and made it into a video, and what you saw was the result. And all this is surprisingly simple to do in PowerPoint, and let me show you how you too can create really captivating videos using nothing else but PowerPoint. Here I am on a new slide. The first step to create a video, as you might have guessed, is to create your slide deck. I'm going to create a simple video with three slides. The first one has just the text, which is animated. Second one will have a picture with text, and the third one will have video with text. We will incorporate all these elements into a video we create. First, let me add some simple text. Let me go to the text box tool in Auto Shapes Gallery. When you click on the Auto Shapes Gallery, you'll be able to find that under Basic Shapes. You click on that text box and then you write your text. In this case, I'm going to say you can add, and I'm going to use an interesting handwritten font for this. So let me select this text, go to the font type. I want to use a font called Pacifico. So let me go down to P and here I have Pacifico. Let me click on it and let me increase the size substantially so it is clearly visible. So we have got our first line in place. Let us add another line. And here I'm going to say animated text, and I'm going to use a different kind of a font for this. Let me use 2cm MT condensed extra bold. I'm going to increase the size like the way that I did earlier, and I'm going to place this right under this. Let us add some animation to this. I'm going to have this text box enter with a fly-in animation. So let us go to animations and say fly-in, and this flies in from top. And let us have the second one animate with a fly-in from left. So let us go to fly-in and say from left. Let us go to start and have this happen with previous. When I go to animation pane, you can see we have two animation events. I want to have the first animation event to happen with previous. So let us select the first one and say with previous. So we have two animation events and both of them happen with previous. When I go to slideshow, this is how the animation happens. Excellent. We have got our first slide ready. Let us create the second slide with an image. So let me go here to the thumbnail view and hit enter, and that adds a new slide. First, let us insert an image. Let me go to insert, go to pictures, and I can choose stock images, online pictures, or this device. I can select one of the images that I already have downloaded. So let me click on this device. And I have so many images here. Maybe the one that I want is this one, and I can say insert. This I can enlarge so that it fills the entire image. So let me click and drag it so it corresponds with the top left corner of the slide. Then click and drag from the bottom. You can see the size of the image and the size of the slide don't seem to match. So I need to ensure that this image is cropped into the slide ratio of this slide. We all know that in modern PowerPoint, the slide aspect ratio is 16:9. So I'm going to select this image, go to Picture Format tab, go to Crop, click on the drop-down menu, go to Aspect Ratio, and use this option here called 16:9. Let me click on that and you can see that instantly PowerPoint crops this image to match the slide aspect ratio. So let me click outside. Now let me click and drag this so it corresponds with the top left corner. Then click and drag from the bottom. Now I have the image completely occupying the slide area. Now I'm going to write my text on top of this image. So let me go to the text box tool and I'm going to write my text here. This is text over image. let me add some space here. Let me use a thicker font. In this case, it is 2cmt condensed extra bold. Once again, let us really increase the size. And maybe we can have this in a white colored font. So let me choose this. And that looks beautiful. So I have got this text on the image. I can add a simple animation for this text. So let me select the text box and go to animations. And let us have a fade in animation to happen. And this happens with previous. Then let us go to the thumbnail, right click and say new slide. Here I'm going to insert a video. Let me go to the insert tab. To the far right corner, I can see that we have the option for video. Let me click on it. And since I'm using Office 365 subscription, I have this option for stock videos. So I can insert a stock video that comes right inside PowerPoint. If not, you can choose one of the online video sources or this device. Let me click on this device. I have already downloaded a video onto my downloads folder. So let me go to the folder, select this particular video and say insert. Now you can see I have the video inserted. Now I can change the playback option for this video. Let me select this video, go to playback and say this needs to play back automatically. And then let me add another text right on top of this video. So let me go to the previous slide and then pick up this text which is already animated. Press Ctrl C to copy and then come back here and press Ctrl V to paste. And we will call this text over video. And maybe I can have this in black color. I can change the font color. I've already got animation for this text because I only copied the text from the previous slide where the animation was applied. So you can see that the animation carries on. So we have created our slide deck. Now we need to add transitions so that everything flows automatically and it looks far more professional. Now when I go to the first slide, I can see that it doesn't take much time for the audience to go through this content. So I want this slide to move automatically after a couple of seconds. So let me go to transitions and say this moves after 2 seconds. So I can add the seconds here by clicking on up or down. So here I have clicked on up to add more seconds. Now let us go to the second slide and add a different kind of transition. Go to transitions. Let me click on the drop-down menu to see the various options available. I really like this option called page curl, and that is how this slide gets introduced. And right after that, we will have this animation playing, which inserts the text. Excellent. Then let us go to the last one. And then let us add another kind of transition. Of course, it is always a good idea to keep your transitions in a certain pattern so your audience doesn't get distracted. Here, I am adding different types of transitions just to show the possibilities. Let me go down and see what other type we have. Maybe I can use switch and that switches to the next slide. This looks beautiful. Now we have got all our animations in place. Now, if you remember, the first slide automatically moves after 2 seconds. Now, we need to instruct the amount of time that we need the audience to spend on the second one. Maybe I can use 3 seconds here. And then the last one needs to move automatically after, say, 5 seconds. So let me add the 5 seconds here. Now, I need to add some music. So let me go to the first slide. To add music, you go to the Insert tab. Go all the way to the right and click on audio. You can use audio on your PC, which is whatever that you've downloaded earlier, or you can record audio. In this case, I don't really want to record any new audio. So I'm going to use audio on my PC. Let me click on that option. I already downloaded an audio piece onto my computer and it is in music folder. So I select that piece and say insert. Now you can see I have the icon for audio. I can place it over here. Now I need to make a few adjustments as far as the way in which this audio plays. So let me go to this option called play in background in the playback option. So when I click on play in background, a few of these options automatically get checked. It means that this audio will start automatically. It will play across slides and the music will loop until stopped and the icon will not show during show. So that is how it is. Now let us go to the first slide and see how the whole presentation plays. So let me go to slideshow. Here you can see we have the music going on and the transition happens after a certain predetermined time. you can see that the text is animating right over video, images and everything, and it's beautiful. Now let me hit escape. Now I want to convert this into video. All I need to do for that is go to File, then go to Export. Then you have the second option here called as Create a Video. And here you have the option for resolutions. When I click on this option, I have the option to choose Ultra HD, which is 4K, or Full HD, HD, Standard, etc. I like to have Full HD because this is a good enough quality for me to upload onto YouTube. So let me select that option. I don't have to specify the seconds spent on each slide. I've already made my inputs earlier. So I just need to click on Create Video, and I can specify the place where I want to save this. Let us say I want to save this on the desktop. So let me go to desktop, and I'm going to call this sample 1, and I'm going to say save. Now, as soon as I did that, you can see that PowerPoint is already converting this into MP4. And once this bar gets completed, you will have a video file, which is MP4, which is ready to be uploaded on YouTube or host in any place you want. Now we have the conversion done. Let me go to a new presentation. Let me choose a blank layout. Let me change the color of the background so the video can clearly be seen. Let me use maybe something as dark as this. Here I want to insert my video. So let us go to Insert, go to Video, click on this device. We have already stored our video on the desktop and it is called Sample 1. So let us select that and say Insert. And that inserts this video. You can see that it is full page. If you want, you can always resize the size of the video. And I've kept it right in the center. Now I need to make one final adjustment for the playback of this video in this new presentation. Let me go to Playback and say this needs to play automatically. Excellent. Now let us go to Slideshow and see how this slide plays. Let me hit Escape. Can you see here? We have created a beautiful video right inside PowerPoint and stored it in the MP4 format, which can be used in any way we want. So that is how you convert PowerPoint to video. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give this video a like, share it with your friends, and hit the subscribe button to encourage us to create more such videos. You can also watch these other videos on the screen to learn more about simple video creation. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.